From whom stand to the alma mater, flame of love that beam shining brighter, held it shall be cheer forever, love and service all we uphold. It's the pride of dear Visayana, joyful hearts we see together, seek the truth, the fountain of knowledge, draw near, alma mater dear. We sail onward, keep the UV spirit burning. Our beloved dear alma mater, with our hearts we pray forevermore.
We say onwards, go, go, go! Love us in humanity, with the world we love to see.
We will always be the witness as to thee. We sail onward, keep the UV spirit.
Good day, everyone, and welcome to Criminal Law Book 1 for criminology students.
So this is based on the revised Penal Code Book 1, all right? Let's start our discussion by defining what is meant by criminal law. Unsa man ning criminal law? When we talk about criminal law, this is a branch of law or division of municipal law which defines crimes. Tanawa ha, tulo na siya ka-aspect. It defines crimes, treats of their nature, and provides for their punishment. When you talk about defines crimes, ang criminal law, nagsulti na to kung unsa may iyang gi-consider as a crime. Iya pong gisulti na to kung how are we going to treat the nature of this particular crime. And criminal law itself also provides for the punishment. Okay? Kung mayong kag ang crime is rape, you know what constitutes rape under the revised penal code, and you will also see in the revised penal code the punishment for rape. This is criminal law. Okay? Balik na ko, it is that branch or division of municipal law which defines crimes, treats of their nature, and provides for their punishment. Later on, before ta mo wind up sa itong discussion, pangutan-on ta mo ha, ako mong tagsa-tagsaon kung unsay definition sa criminal law. So you better be familiar with the definition of criminal law. Now, a crime is either an act or omission. Unsa man ang act? It is imong gibuhat. When you say act, imong gibuhat. Omission, wa ni mo gibuhat. So there can be instance nga naka'y buhaton, makonsiderar na under the revised penal code as a crime. Naapoy instance nga wa kay gibuhat apan the law would consider it as a crime. Okay? If it is punishable under the law, it could either be an act or omission that is considered a crime. Okay? Now, if that particular crime is punishable under the revised penal code, kibaman mo on sa revised penal code, no mo na siya ang kodigo penal, ang libro kung diin gibutang unsa ang mga krimen o unsa ang mga definition sa krimen o unsa ang mga punishment behind ana nga mga krimen, okay? Kung ang crime na aning makit-an sa revised penal code, ang tawag ana nga crime is felony. Okay? If a crime is punished by the revised penal code, we call that crime as a felony. Okay? Kung ang violation is found in a special law, kung may nag-special law, balaod ni siya apan wala dito sa revised penal code. Nahimo na siyang krimen by subsequent legislations. Okay? Ang Kongreso nagbuhat nagbalaod nga kani siya ato ninggi considerar nga krimen. Wala ni nato na appeal sa revised penal code kay dugay naman kay itong revised penal code. So ang Congress, what they did, they would craft laws. We call this special laws. Kung ang krimen is penalized under a special law, we call that particular crime as an offense. Okay? Offense. Kuha rata, guys? Napamudya?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, if it is punished by an ordinance, kung ordinansa ang nagpunish ng a particular act or omission, we call that particular act or omission as an infraction of an ordinance. Okay? Kani, ako ni siyang gitagsa-tagsa because commonly I've been reviewing for what do you call this? Board exams for criminology, no? And I noticed sa mga exams sa criminology, you have actually mga multiple choice questions. And ang common sa multiple choice questions is either imong identify, mayong sila, it is the branch of law that defines crime, streets of their nature, and provides for their punishment. I'm sorry guys. Okay, ang in the exam, sa inyong board exam, you can notice na mayroon na siya, it is that branch of law or municipal law which defines crime, streets of the nature, and provides further punishment. Is it A, criminal law, B, civil law, C, commercial law? Ingana na siya ang mga exam. So it's very important nga kabaw ka sa concept, kabaw ka sa definition. Also, nasa na sa inyong exam, pwede sa na siyang mayingon, blank is an act or omission which is punishable by law. If kanara siya, very generic question, the answer would be, unsa man, crime, di ba? Pero ngayon ang question, this is a crime punishable by the revised penal code. O, ngayon na siya, A, felony, B, offense, C, infraction of ordinance, D, all of the above. So, by learning the definition of each particular type of law that would penalize an act or omission, pag-identify, di ba? It's either a felony, an offense, or an infraction of an ordinance. So, unsa to? Ato ko nung balikon, kung maingon kag ang revised penal code ang nag-consider niya as a crime, what do we call that? We call that, Russell, as, unsa man? Yes, Ophelia. Unsa man, Ophelia? Kung ang revised penal code ang nag-considerar niya as a crime, we call that as, unsa man?
Felony, ma'am.
Yes, that's correct. How about kung ang special law ang nag-penalize niya as a crime, Ophelia, what do we call that particular crime?
Offense.
If it is punished by an ordinance, Ophelia, unsa man na siya, Ophelia?
Infraction of an ordinance.
All right. Karon, Ophelia, can you define criminal law without looking at the notes? Kalimot ka?
Pare, mahinumduman, ma'am. Pero, aw. Sige, lang. Try na lang, ma'am.
Sige, try it.
It defines crimes, traits of their nature, and provides for their punishment.
Yeah. That's very good, Ophelia, ha? Ang criminal law, dali rakay ni mo siya mahinumduman, kaya tulo raman siya ka-aspect. D, T, og P. Una, when you say D, it actually defines crimes. Diba, Ophelia? Defines crimes. T stands for treats of their nature and P provides for the punishment. So to, defines crimes, treats of their nature, and provides for their punishment. So kung kabaw na kaana, eh, na kay 1 point sa imong exam, diba, Ophelia? That's very good, Ophelia. Keep it up. So ang uban
yes,
akong pangutan, thank you Ophelia. Ang uban akong pangutan unya before ta mag-end sa klase kung unsa ang definition sa criminal law, okay? Now, what is the nature of a criminal law? A criminal law is actually a substantive law because it defines the state's right to inflict punishment and the liability of the offender. Under the police power of the state, the state is actually justified in punishing crimes in order to administer justice. The state has an existence of its own to maintain, a conscience to assert, and moral principles to be vindicated. So penal justice rests primarily on the moral rightfulness of the punishment imposed. Okay, it is a substantive law, timan ininyo. Also, it is a public law. Nganong public law man siya? Because it deals with the relation of the individual with the state. Alright? Now, on to the general rule. As a general rule, the power to actually define and punish an act as a crime is vested with the legislative body of the government. I know nga some of you here, if not all, have already taken up the Philippine Constitution, correct? And under the Philippine Constitution, there are three branches of the government. These three branches of the government are as follows. Una, ang legislative department. Ikaduha, ang executive department. Ang ikatulo, ang judicial department. When we talk about the judicial department, kani sila ang mag-interpret sa balaod. Sila mo moingon nga mauni pasabot sa balaod, kaning balaod na wala ni nagsubay sa ato ang constitution. Maunay role sa judiciary. And when we talk about the judiciary, mauni sila ang Supreme Court, ang Court of Appeals, ang Regional Trial Court, ang Municipal Trial Courts. Kaning mga korte nato sa Pilipinas. Mauna ang naglangkob sa judicial department or sa judiciary. Okay, I hope you're following. Now, when we talk about the executive department, ang executive department actually implements, executes the law. Mauni ang branch sa gobyerno nga magpatuman sa balaod. And when you become members of the Philippine National Police, you become under this department, the executive department. You become enforcers of the law. Na ay balaod, ang inyong role, i-implement ang balaod, i-enforce ang balaod. And this is headed by the President of the Republic of the Philippines. That's the executive department. Now, when we talk about the legislative body of the government, mauni sila ang gitagaan sa constitution ug power nga mo define ug mo punish sa usa ka act as a crime. Nganuman, sila man ang magbuhat ug balaod. Sila mo ingon nga kaninga particular act under the law is not constitutional. This particular act is considered a crime. This particular act is considered an omission. We cannot say that automatically because before ka makaingon nga ang usa ka butang illegal, ang usa ka butang kay unconstitutional, ang usa ka butang kay dili pwede nimong buhaton, ang usa ka butang usa ka krimen, kailangan nay balaod nga nag-ingon ana. Okay? And kinsa may nagbuhat sa balaod? The department that actually makes the laws is actually the legislative body of the government. The legislative body of the government is considered, is what you call this, it is actually composed of two houses. The first is the upper house, which is the Senate, and the second is the lower house, which is the House of Representatives. Kanang duha ka houses, muna sila ang magduso, magbuhat, mag-usab, magpapas sa usa ka balaod. Tanan nimong buhaton sa usa ka balaod, it is lodged with the legislative body of the government. Sama aning revised penal code. Kaning revised penal code and other special laws are actually created and made by the legislative body of the government. It's with the Congress. Okay? I hope klaro na siya. But by way of exception, ladies and gentlemen, to the principle of non-delegation of legislative powers, the power may be delegated to the chief executive in cases of extreme national emergency as provided for in the 1987 Constitution. Because as a general rule, kanimagong tulo ka branches sa government, nana sila'y tagsa-tagsa ka mga power. And when you are given that power, you cannot delegate that power. Okay? Muna general rule. But by way of exception to that particular general rule, ang legislative department is actually authorized to delegate some powers to the chief executive, who is the president. Kanisiya in cases only of extreme national emergency. Kanang naay buhaton nga balaod for national emergency, unya urgent na kaayo. And if you go through the Congress, dugay pa kaayo, kanapay first reading, third reading, second reading, third reading, magdebate pa ng mga kongresista, ang mga senador. So, kung naay extreme national emergency, the president is given the legislative power para magbuhat og usa ka balaod. Only to address this particular extreme national emergency. Okay? Klaro ra, guys? Napamudya, guys? Okay. Let's now go to the constitutional limitations on the passage of a penal law. Okay? Una nga limitation is that the Congress cannot actually pass an ex post facto law or a bill of attainder. Timanin na inyo, bisan pag ang Kongreso has the power to actually make laws, they cannot pass a law which is considered to be an ex post facto law or a bill of attainder. Unsa mang mga balaod na ang makonsiderar nato nga ex post facto law? Una, when it makes an act done before the passage of a law and which was innocent when done and punishes such an act. Pasabot lang ani, kung usa ka butang paghimo ni mo di pa krimen, unya later on ang Kongreso nagbuhat og balaod, gihimo na nga krimen, unya ipenalize ka, that is considered to be an ex post facto law. Example lang ana, let's say gahapon. Gahapon ang panugal dili pa krimen. So nanugal ka, Ophelia. Gahapon ha, gahapon January, unsa man gahapon, January 5, Ophelia. Nanugal ka gahapon, nagtaksi bron, okay? Nya example lang gahapon ang pagtaksi dili pa krimen. Karong adlaw ang Kongreso nagpasar og balaod nga ang pagtaksi krimen na, okay? Pagka ugma gipailan ka sa let's say MTC og kaso nga pagpanugal on the basis nga pag January 5 nanugal ka, Ophelia. Unya kay na naman kunoy napasar nga balaod pag January 6 nga ang sugal usa na nakakrimen, gipailan ka kaso pag January 7. Pwede ba nang himuon, Ophelia?
Yes, ma'am.
Pwede ka file ag kaso, Ophelia? Sa imuhang gihimo nga pagpanugal pag January 5, bisan pa man pag January 5 ang pagpanugal, dili pa krimen. Dili, no?
Dili, dili Mungoro, ma'am?
Dili.
Dili, Ras? Nga naman, Ras?
Kay gahapon man to. And then, bago lang gipasa sa January 6, like, karon pa January 6 gipasa sa Kongreso ang ano, ang kaso.
Mm.
And then gipailan ka ang anong gipailan man nga last. Ano, wala may ano sakto na ebidensya ang anong gipailan ra siya kaso kay gahapon. More.
Mm. Mm. Okay, Ras. Thank you, Ras. Nga naman, sakto si Ras partly but primarily because that law nga gihimo pag January 6 is an ex post facto law. Unsa man itong ex post facto law ganitong giingon, kanang himuon nga kriminal ang usa ka butang nga paghimo dili pa krimen. Okay, mo na ipasabot sa ex post facto law. It makes criminal an act done before the passage of a law and which was innocent when done and punishes such an act. So, kung si Ophelia nanugal pag January, kano sa to? January 4?
5.
Pag January 5, may krimen nga nag-ingon ng pagpanugal, usa na ka-crime. So, dili siya ma-penalize for a law passed in January 6. Kaya nga naman, kana siya kung iyan ang i-penalize ang usa ka butang nga gibuhat sa sakataw prior to the passage of that law, kana nga balaod, mahimong ex post facto law, and it cannot pass. Okay? Dili na siya pwede nga balaod. Muro na ipasabot ang ex post facto law, guys. Dayon, kung ang usa ka balaod aggravates a crime or makes it greater than it was when committed. Same example, si Ophelia nanugal pag January 5, but this time around, ang pagpanugal kay usa na kakrimen. Example lang niha. So pag January 5 nanugal si Ophelia, ang sugal ang penalty ato 1 year. Karon pag January 6 nagpasar ang Kongreso og balaod nga giamendar ang penalty when it comes to pagpanugal. Gihimo na ang penalty nga 2 years. Pwede ba nga inig mahimo, pwede ba nga og makonbikto si Ophelia inig let's say January 7, ang penalty nga i-impose sa iyaha is 2 years and not 1 year? Ras, what do you think? Unsa man nga penalty ang i-impose kang Ophelia kung makonbikto siya inig ka January January 7? Will it be 2 years or 1 year? Yes, Edmond, you are raising your hand. Ikaw, Edmond.
Okay, covered to man siya sa 1 year na na-impose ang pan, penal laws.
Yes. So, 1 year, Edmond?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, that's correct. 1 year ang iyahang penalty. Nga naman, kung imong tumanon ang 2 years, kana nga balaod becomes an ex post facto law because it aggravates a crime and makes it greater than it was. When we say aggravate, mas gibugatan ba? Nakuha mo? So kung ang usa ka balaod mo aggravate sa usa ka crime and makes it greater than it was when committed, it becomes an ex post facto law. So daghang klase ang ex post facto law, ha? Dayon changes with respect to the punishment and inflicts a greater punishment than the law annexed the crime when committed. Similar lang ni sila aning number 2, but kanilang number 1 is ang crime. Ang number 3 lang is actually with respect to the punishment. Okay? Karon alters the legal rules on evidence and authorizes conviction upon less or different testimony than the law required at the time of the commission of an offense. Unsa may pasabot ani? Let's say homicide. Ang element sa homicide is there has to be a body of the crime. There has to be a killing, di ba? Kailangan na ay pagpamatay. Karon, let's say a law is passed eradicating these requisites. Niingon nga, as long as makita ang body of the crime, automatic homicide na. Kana siya nga law becomes an ex post facto law because it authorizes conviction upon a less or a different testimony than the law required at the time of the commission of the offense. Kailangan kung unsang element sa crime nga gi-require at the time of the commission of the crime, mauna siya ang i-follow and not a law nga passed after nasa commission of the crime or during the pendency of the action. Otherwise, it becomes an ex post facto law. Okay? Now, if it assumes to regulate civil rights and remedies only, but in effect imposes penalty or deprivation of a right for something which, when done, was lawful, similar ni siya aning uban, deprives a person accused of a crime of some lawful protection to which he has become entitled, such as the protection of a proclamation of amnesty. Kani, dayon, kanus amang ka makaingon nga ang usa ka balaod is actually a bill of attainder. We have kaniha guys, ako lang balikon, kailangan inyuhan ning tan-awon ha kung unsa ning mga instances kay ang common na nga pangutana niya sa inyong board mo. Ingon na siya. The following is considered an ex post facto law except. Okay? So ang naa diri puro na siya ex post facto law. Ang wa diri mao nay answer kung mao nay pangutana, okay? The following is an ex post facto law except. Oh, ihatag ni tanan choices but naay usa nga masaag kung panalitan ang bill of attainder ang ibutang nila diha nga usa sa mga choices, automatic your answer would be bill of attainder. Now, what is bill of attainder? This is actually a legislative act which inflicts punishment without the benefit of a judicial trial. Its essence is the substitution of a legislative act for a judicial determination of guilt. Kani siya happens when automatic ang usa ka balaod mo ingon na nga guilty ka, wala nay trial nga mahitabo. That's a bill of attainder and it cannot be done. Because as I've said earlier, ang mukandak sa trial, ang mukandak sa interpretation of a particular law, or ang muingon nga ang usa ka tao nakakumit og actually crime or guilty or not guilty of a crime is actually the judiciary or the judicial department. And if ang legislature would make a law nga mag-inflict og punishment without the benefit of a judicial trial, kana siya nga law becomes a bill of attainder. All right? Now on to other constitutional limitations. You have to remember that a penal law must be general in application. Otherwise, it would violate the Equal Protection Clause of the Constitution. And I'm sure you have discussed Equal Protection Clause of the Constitution in your study of the Philippine Constitution. Ang akwa lang aning i-reiterate is that kung magbuhat og balaod, kailangan applicable to all. Dili pwede nga na certain class lang. Di pwede nga ang dakpon diha sa kulon for jaywalking, ang mga gwapura, ang mga batignang pasagdan. Okay? Because penal laws must be general in application. Bisag batignang, bisag gwapo, bisag di kayo gwapo, di kayo batignang, tanan covered na sa usa ka law. Because penal laws must be general in application. All right? Otherwise, ni unang constitution, it would violate the Equal Protection Clause of the Constitution. Also, you have to remember that Congress cannot provide for a cruel, degrading, or inhuman punishment, nor can it impose excessive fines. Nilabang ra ka diha sa kulon o jaywalking, unya, pabayron ka 1 million. Diba? That is excessive and it cannot be done. And niingon ang balaod nga kung ang usa ka kung ang Congress mapasar og balaod, kailangan ang balaod is commensurate with the offense committed. Dili pwede nga ning labang rakas kulon og jaywalking tagaan ka og fine nga 1 million. Kailangan commensurate siya, equal siya to the offense committed. Or let's say ning commit kag rape unya ang ihatag nga penalty sa imuha is just the payment of 1,000. Diba? Mura ra kag nipalit. So, it cannot be done. It has to be commensurate with the crime committed. Now on to the characteristics of criminal law. Characteristics of criminal law, tulo ni ka characteristics. Ang una, generality, principle of generality. Ikaduha, the principle of prospectivity. Ang ikatulo, the principle of territoriality. Let's start discussing the principle of generality. When we talk about the principle of generality, it only means that penal laws and those of public security and safety shall be obligatory upon all who live or sojourn in the Philippine territory, subject to the principles of public international law. Unsa may pasabot ani? Kung naatay diri balaod sa Pilipinas, especially penal laws, may kag penal laws, o sa itong penal laws, usa ka balaod nga naghatag og penalty. Either the penalty is the payment of a fine or imprisonment. Kaning penal laws, applicable ni siya sa tanang tao diri sa Philippine territory. Bisan pa mag-Amerikano na siya, bisan pa man og African na siya, Australian na siya, Filipino na siya, as long as kanang tawhana naa diri sa Pilipinas, niingon man diri, whether he or she is living or sojourning in the Philippine territory, as long as naa siya sud sa atong nasud, kana siya covered siya by our penal laws. So kung panalitan si Edmond usa ka ka-Amerikano, kas University of the Visayas kay imong gimit si Ophelia dito na chatmate mo ya nag-eyeball mong duha o ya nilabang ka dito sa Colon unya go pa man gidakop ka for jaywalking, you cannot say ngadto kang traffic enforcer nga si Nicoy nga hey Mr. Nicoy, you cannot apprehend me yo because I am an American citizen yo, I'm not covered by your laws yo. You cannot do that, Edmund, because the law is very specific that penal laws are actually obligatory upon all who sojourn in the Philippine territory. Unsa may pasabot anong sojourn? Bisag di siya taga diri. As long as naa siya sa Pilipinas and he or she commits a crime, obligatory na sa iyaha ug manubag siya for the crime that he or she committed. Okay, that's the principle of generality. But na na exception ang atong principle of generality wherein even if ni sojourn ang usa ka tawo diri sa nasod foreigner and he commits a crime, dili siya pwedeng ipenalize. Ngano man? Because niingon ang balaod, if that particular person is covered by principle of public international law. Kinsa man ning mga tawo nga covered by the principle of public international law? Mao ning mga membro sa diplomatic corps of a country who enjoy criminal immunity such as sovereigns and other heads and chief of state, mga ambassadors, let's say si Edmond in this case taga Amerika pero ambassador siya, din mo pwedeng dakpon because exempt sila from criminal liability. Okay, minister plenipotentiary, minister's resident, mga charge d'affaires and mga attaché, aning mga members sa diplomatic corps. Okay, also cases covered by treaty or treaty stipulations. Ang Pilipinas ug Amerika baron ni enter og treaty, unya ningon sila nga ang violation sa traffic laws kay dili malayable ilang citizen, unya ang Pilipino sad kumatog Amerika makakumit og violation sa traffic law, dili sad siya malayable. Mao na siya example sa treaty stipulation, enter sila into a treaty ba, exempting each citizens from liabilities when they go into each other's country. So that's an exception nga bisan pa man, if you commit a crime, you cannot be penalized even if in the country. Another exception is those covered by laws of preferential application. This is quite similar with number two. And di lang kay ni nato i-discuss because this is very technical. And if you're law students, kana siya required. But since criminology ta and your focus is only on the basic concepts of criminal law, mo focus na ta sa mga basic concepts. All right? Ikaduha nga characteristic, as I've mentioned earlier, is the principle of territoriality. Unsa tong una nga principle na itong agi-discuss, Edmond? Ang principle of? Edmond?
Yeah.
Unsa itong ganiha, Mon?
The principle of generality, ma'am.
Okay, that's good.
Am I...
Thank you, Edmond. So, karon ay ikaduha is the principle of territoriality. When we talk about territoriality, this only means that penal laws take effect only within the limits of the Philippine territory. It cannot penalize a crime committed outside the country, even if the same be committed by any of its citizens. Unsay pasabot aning territoriality? Ang pasabot lang ani is kung ni-committer ka og crime within the Philippine territory, liable ka. And if you commit a crime outside of the Philippine territory, bisan pag citizen ka, di ka pwedeng ikiha dire. Unsa may pasabot, unsa may example ani? Example si Edmond o si Ophelia managtiayon. Okay? Example lang ni. Minyo si Edmond o si Ophelia, apan si Edmond gusto siya nga tagaan o maayo o hayahay nga kinabuhi si Ophelia. So nihangyo siya kang Ophelia. And siya, day Ophelia, tuguti tangko day Ophelia nga manimpad o muadto sa laing nasod. Muadto kong Dubai, Ophelia. Okay rin mo day Ophelia. So si Ophelia sanin siya, oh sige Edmond, kung unsa imong gustong buhaton, suportaan ti ka. So ning larga si Edmond, nato siya ang Dubai. Ani, wapan ni COVID, ani ha? Nato ka Edmond o Dubai, unya dito nakapag mangkag mas nindot pang Ophelia, ang panganiya si Hazel. Okay? Pag ato ni mog Dubai, kita ni mo si Sitch, oh, guwapa ni da, ganaan ko ni da, mas guwapa ni sa kong asawa nga si Ophelia. So yung mong gibuhat Edmond, nagpakasal ka ni Hazel dito sa Dubai. Regardless of the fact that you are actually married here in the Philippines. So nahog nagduha ni mong asawa. Karon Edmond, iguli ni Mudris Pilipinas, Edmond, pwede ba kang ikiha ni Ophelia o bigami? Diba, bigami man na, kanang makipakasal ka o kaduha, katulo, that's actually bigamous marriage. Can Ophelia, Edmond, sue you for bigamy on the ground that you actually married Hazel in Dubai? Even during the subsistence of your marriage here in the Philippines. Pwede Edmond, ikiha ka Edmond ni Ophelia Edmond?
No ma'am, kay ang nagpakasal ko sa laimang territory ma'am.
Ah. Sakto Ophelia or pwede ni mo siya ikiha Ophelia?
Dili ma'am.
Dili ni mo
makiha? Kaya dito man siya nagpakasal sa Dubai ug lain.
Alright. I like this class ha. Dali lang kayo magkasabot. Thank you Ophelia and Edmond na tong love team karong hapuna. Anyway, because penal laws actually take effect only within the limits of the Philippine territory, si Edmond in this example will not be penalized here in the country, okay? Kaya nga naman, ang krimen, iyamang gikumiter outside of the country and dili man ta ana, pumantay jurisdiction ana, okay? So si Edmond, bisan pa man o nagpakasal siya sa Dubai, dili siya pwedeng ikiha ni Ophelia for bigamy here in the country. But akong question rin, Ophelia, valid ba itong iyang pagpakasal dito? Gawa sa nasad? Ang Hazel?
Basin, ma'am.
ma'am, pwede rin siya, ma'am?
Edmond, ito mo, Edmond. Akisam to?
Ay, Russell, ma'am, Russell.
Russ.
Ma'am, naka-question, ma'am. Pwede din, ma'am? Diba mo consult mo anak man ang asawa na ipa-deport ning asawa kay nangwani ng babae ana ba?
May nanak man na sa tulpo no mo sila sa tulpo.
Pa tulpo.
Pakasal sa taglaid.
Okay. De okay, to answer the question earlier kung valid ba ang kaminyo ni Edmond o ni Hazel sa Dubai, di siya valid. Because si Edmond is still married here in the Philippines and ang prinsipyo ana kung minyo si Adres Pilipinas, bisag asa pa siya mo adto, minyo gina siya, okay? And if he marries another woman outside of the country, di tuod siya makiha diri og bigamy, pero si Ophelia can always file for psychological violence under RA 9262 kanang vouse. Kaya ang scope sa vouse, ladies and gentlemen, is very huge. Dako kaayo, very vast, very wide. Nga bisag unsa pa na nga act imong buhaton isip usa ka lalaki nga makapa-stress sa babay, maka-hurt sa babay, makahatag niya wounded feelings, no? Pwede gyud kang ikiha niya diri sa Pilipinas bisan pa magnaa ka outside of the country. So, mo na imong giingon siguro ras nga uban moingon man, ma'am. Pwede na, ma'am. Nga uban, ma'am, kay moingon man nga ipa-deport lang bana. Yes, they would tell that because they are planning to actually file for violation of RA 9262, particularly psychological violence. Pero akong question ganiha is with respect to bigamy man. So ang bigamy, dili siya pwedeng makiha because bigamy was committed outside of the country. But with respect to violation of RA 9262, particularly psychological violence, you will learn this in your special penal laws, guys. Nga, bisan pa man og ang gibuhat sa usa ka lalaki na agawa sa natsud kay na stress man ang asawa diri sa Pilipinas, kanang asawa ha pwedeng mukiha og violation of RA 9262 psychological violence. Okay, I hope that's clear. Kuha ra ras?
Yes, ma'am.
Karon unsa may mo encompass sa Philippine territory? Ang constitution niingon nga the Philippine territory is actually the territory defined in Article 1 of the 1987 Constitution that actually defines national territory. And in its vein, the Philippines adopts the archipelagic doctrine, which mandates the outlining of the imaginary line starting from the lowest watermark and connecting the outermost portion of the territory in defining the limits of the national territory. The entire archipelago is regarded as one integrated unit instead of being fragmented into so many islands. Kita ang kanubag, buwag mo ng Pilipinas, pero ang pag-define na to sa national territory, giisip na nga usa ka tibuok nga territory instead of being fragmented into so many islands. Okay? Now on to the composition of the national territory. Naatay gitawag og territorial jurisdiction kanang bodies of land. Naatay gitawag nga fluvial jurisdiction kanang maritime and interior and internal waters. We also have the so-called aerial jurisdiction kanang nasa atmosphere, okay? Pataas paubos og kanang yuta ato ana, okay, within the Philippine territory. However, bisan pa man og niingon ta nga by the principle of territoriality, a Filipino citizen cannot be penalized in the country if he or she commits a crime outside of the Philippine territory. Ang Article 2 of the Revised Penal Code would tell us nga ang penal laws may also apply outside of the Philippine territory if this is committed by any person who shall commit an offense while on a Philippine ship or airship. So bisan pa man og ang crime was committed outside na of our territorial jurisdiction, if ang usa ka tawo ni commit og crime while naa siya sa usa ka Philippine ship or airship, he or she may be penalized here in our country. When can we say that a ship or an airship is actually a Philippine ship or airship? Kana sa man ta kaingon nga kana siya nga ship, kana siya nga airship kay Pilipinas na siya nga ship or airship. What's the basis for determining the ship or nationality of the ship? We always go down to, or we always go back to the registration, okay? If it is registered in the Philippines, that ship or airship, as the case may be, is considered as a Philippine ship or airship, all right? Now, if a crime is actually committed on board a foreign vessel and it is a merchant vessel, na ay two rules ana with respect to the jurisdiction. Una, ang French rule, which states that the crime committed on board a foreign merchant vessel while on the waters of another country are not triable in that country. Unless kuno, kung kana nga crime affect the peace and security and safety of the state and the state is in danger. Okay? Ang ikaduha nga rule is the so-called English rule. Ang English rule niingon nga crimes are triable in that country unless they merely affect the internal management of the vessel. Okay? In the Philippines, what we follow is the so-called English rule. Okay? Kung ipangutana ni sa inyong board unya, ang gifollow nato sa Pilipinas, English rule, which provides that crimes are triable in that country unless they merely affect the internal management of the vessel. All right. Nonetheless, you also have to consider the provisions of Section 15, Rule 110 of the Rules of Criminal Procedure. Later on in your study of criminology, you will have criminal procedure, no? Murag CLJ3, masiguro na. And you will learn unsa ning Section 15, Rule 110. But in passing, let's just read through Section 15 of Rule 110, which provides that the crime or the criminal action is instituted and tried in the court of the municipality or territory where the offense was committed or any of its essential ingredients occurred. Okay? Ikaduha, where the crime is committed in a train, balik ka na itong una ha, kung may ngong kag, as a general rule, kung may ngong kag criminal action, asa mo na nimo siya i-file, asa mo na siya hiringon, adto na siya nimong i-file sa lugar kung asa gi-commit ang crime or kung asa ang usa sa mga elements ni occur. Alright? Kung example, kidnapping. Ang kidnapping, it's like a, kuan mo good, a moving crime ba? Taga konsolasyon ka, diri ka gi-kidnap sa konsolasyon. But during sa kidnapping, gidala-dala ka o Mandawi, Cebu City, and all that. So, asa man ka mo file o kaso for kidnapping in this instance? Russell.
Asa to ma'am? Asa mo file o...
Asa man mo i-file ang kidnapping?
Sa ano ma'am? Sa iyang... Sa... Ami, sa asa siya gi-kidnap mo?
Asa man siya gi-kidnap?
Sa konsolasyon.
Asa ang crime na itabo mo?
Kung asa siya na crime na ano, sa asa siya na kidnap, anak crime na itabo mo?
So kung asa siya, kung asa gi-commit ang crime, you also consider or that will be your consideration or basis kung asa ka mo institute or kung asa ka mo file sa kaso. Okay? If it is committed in consolasyon, you file the case in consolasyon. Alright? Kaning number letter B niingon, where the crime is committed in a train, an aircraft, or other private or public vehicle in the course of its trip, the criminal action is instituted at the municipality or territory where the same passed during its trip, including the place of departure and the arrival. Unsa may pasabot ani? Kung ang krimen gi-commit sa train, sa aircraft, or other public or private vehicle, let's say gasumbagay si Russell o si Edmond, kay nag-ilog silang Ophelia, sa train. Ang train, gadagan, between Consolacion, ngadto sa Liloan, niabot sa Compostela, dugay kayo, nahuman ilang sumbagay, la, sige sila sumbagay. Nahuman ilang sumbagay, dito na sa Daan Bantayan. Question, asa man nato kung ang nakasustain o physical injury si Russell niya, gunahan mo kiha si Russell karon. Asa man ka pwedeng mo kiha si Russell o let's say serious or less serious physical injuries against Edmond. Nagsugod sila sumbagay, dress consolation, pap, agi sila siluan, nato Compostela, hantod, nabot sila Daan Bantayan. Asa man ka pwedeng mo kiha ras for the serious or less serious physical injuries? Yes, Daryl, you were raising your hand.
Sa Daan Bantayan, ay di, sa ruta na, ma'am. Kailang, asa sila, gikan, na, ato sila sa... Ma'am?
Based sa letter B, asa man ka mukiha?
Sa Daan Bantayan.
Ito man sila nag-abot, ma'am, na
ang duha mong guru ma'am, I think. Asa siya gikan and then your arrival.
Okay, okay. Atong tanaw ng letter B ha. Ang letter B niingon kung ang crime ko no gi-commit sa train, sa aeroplano, or sa kyanan, in the course of its trip, ang criminal action adto nimo ikiha ko no sa municipality or territory where the same passed during its trip. So asa yung giagian? Bisag asa sa yung giagian including the place of departure asa gikan as well as the place of arrival. So inana ka dako ang imuhang pilianan no, mamili lang ka imo lang MCQ amo ko na ABCD, okay? Are ka ko dire sa Compostela, are ko siluan mo file and all that. Because kung ang crime ko no under letter B is committed while on a train, aircraft or public or private vehicle in the course of its trip, mamili ka where the same pass during the trip including the place of departure and the arrival. Klaro ra, Ras?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Di pwede tanan, ma'am.
Di, sad. Kay usaro mo na kakaso imong ikiha. Pero pwede na mong pilihan ang tanan. Mamili lang ka. Mamili lang ka kasay convenient. Ha? Isa
ma'am,
na, isa to na ingon. Di pwede tanan. Okay. Anyway. Let's now proceed to letter C. Ang letter C ni ingon, where the crime is committed on board a vessel while in the course of its voyage, the criminal action shall be instituted in the court of first port of entry or of any municipality or territory where the vessel passed during the voyage, subject to the generally accepted principles of international law. Kanila, hiyon na to. Ang gisakyan ni Edmond ug ni Russell kay barko, let's say ocean jet. Giyagyan sa ocean jet, konsulasyon, hantun abot sila dito sa Dalmantayan. Asa man ka pwedeng mukihag ka, Surun Ras?
Hello, ma'am.
Dire ka nanukad sa konsulasyon. Nanukad sa konsulasyon. Sukad sa konsulasyon, subagay na mong Edmond la, sige mong sumbagay. Dito mo ni hunong o sumbagay sa Dalmantayan, Ras. Aha man ka pwedeng mukihag, Ras, o physical injury.
Municipality, ma'am. Any gapon. Mura na gapon siya sa B, ma'am. I think.
Yeah. Any municipality or territory where the vessel passed during the voyage as well as the court of first or the court of first port of entry. Walay labot ang departure, okay? Ang iyahang maabtan o ang iyang naagian. Diha nimo pilian kung asa ka mukiha. Alright? And letter D is crimes under katong-atong gi-discuss ganiha Article 2 of the Revised Penal Code. These are cognizable by the court where the criminal action is filed. Kung asa unang gi-file, maunay na ay jurisdiction. Okay? That's Section 15 of Rule 110 of the Rules of Court. Unsa tong una na to under Article 2? Those who should commit while on Philippine ship or airship. Ang ikaduha nga exception nga bisan pa man if this is committed outside of the country, the court of the Philippines will take jurisdiction or cognizance over these cases is ay ikaduha kung ang usa ka tawo ning forge or counterfeit any coin or currency note of the Philippines or obligations and securities issued by the government of the Philippines. Naadto kag China, Ras, unya dito nang forge ka og mga kanang Philippine notes, bank notes, mga kwarta sa Pilipinas, imong gipang forge dito, buhat-buhat kag mga faker nga mga kuan ba, faker nga mga kwarta. So even if you commit forgery or counterfeiting outside of the country, you will still be penalized here in the Philippines because Article 2 would tell us nga even if this is committed outside of the Philippine territory, ang ato ang Korte de Pilipinas will have jurisdiction. Okay? Ang number or letter C should be liable for acts connected with the introduction into the Philippines of the obligations and securities mentioned in the preceding number. Pero naakay kasabwat sa dito sa China, let's say si Edmond niya, si Edmond mo itig padadris kwarta, siya itig, kasi ito, una, ex, itig import dire, import na, no? Itig import dire sa kwarta. So, malayable si Edmond, bisan pa magnaamos China. Okay, kay liable man siya for acts connected with the introduction into the Philippines of those obligations and securities nga gi-counterfeit or gi-forge nimo, Ras. Alright? Letter D, while being public officers or employees should commit an offense in the exercise of their functions. Let's say you are a member of the, or you are an employee of the consular office, or you are the consul of the Philippines dito sa China. If you commit a crime while being a consul in China, you will still be liable here in the Philippines because you are a public officer or employee who is actually committing an offense in the exercise of your function in China. And that's one of the exceptions, okay? Ang letter E, it should commit any crimes against national security and laws of the nations defined in Title 1 of Bukto of the Revised Penal Code. Among ani ka ng mga espionage, mainana ng mga kaso, even if you commit these types of crimes enumerated in your Title 1 of Book 2, even if this is committed outside of the country, you will still be penalized under Article 2 of the Revised Penal Code. Okay? The underlying reason nga nung kaning lima ka mga instances are actually punishable is because ang atuang nasod seeks to preserve the territorial integrity of the Philippines, also to preserve the economic integrity of the country, and to preserve the integrity of the Philippine public administration as well as maintain the continuity and integrity of the state. Okay, I hope that's clear. Ang ikatulong characteristic, which will be our last topic this afternoon, kaya hangap na, ato lang ning i-continue in the next meeting, is the prospectivity of laws. Unsa tong una o ikaduha na to, Ras, nga characteristic of penal laws, Ras? Ras. Napa mo diyan, guys?
Ay, ma'am, nag-CR ka mo.
Ah, sorry. Nag-CR ka? Okay, kisa may mo nag-CR. Edmond! Unsang ito, Edmond, ato ang kuan, Edmond? Ang first two characteristics before aning prospectivity, we talked about the first, what was the one, what was the first, Edmond? Sarili, yes, Sarili. Unsa to Sarili? Unsa to
Sarili? Ang ikaduha to, ma'am, sa.
Ang una o ikaduha, unsa to Sarili? Grace maghan si Sarili good.
Generality ang grupo.
Ah, sige, si Nikoy na lang, Nikoy, ginek.
Kuan, ma'am, generality no. O territoriality.
Og
territorial.
All right, very good. Thank you, Nikoy and Sarah. So, ang una nga characteristic, generality. Ang ikaduha nga characteristic is territoriality. Kani mo ikatulo, prospectivity. Okay? Unsa may pasabot sa prospectivity or a retrospectivity of laws? This only means that law shall have no retroactive effect unless the contrary is provided. Simply put, ang usa ka balaod kung gipasar karon ang application ana karon hangtod ugma og sa umaabot pang adlaw. Dili na siya pwede nga mubalik sa past. Okay, mura ra nag atong mga ex ba din nato balikan bitaw? Future na atong tan-awon kana atong kaugmaon atong hinigugma kato ng future din na ang past, okay? Ing ana ra sad ang balaod. Laws are prospective. Munang kamo gipangbuagan gani mo diha, move on, okay? Always have that prospective character in you, murag balaod, okay? Nga you always look forward and never backward, okay? In anang balaod. Except, of course, kung ang balaod nga nag-ingon mismo nga naa ni retroactive effect, okay? Kaning prospectivity sa usa ka balaod does not have any retroactive effect, okay? Except kung ang balaod mismo ni ingon, this will have a retroactive effect and this law is favorable to the accused. Alright? Kano sa ka na siya may tabo? Niingon ang balaod mismo, kani siya guys, naani siya ay prospective, retroactive application. Panalitan, ni commit o crime si Russell pagka, let's say, gahapon. Ang crime niya ang gi-commit taxi. Ang penalty sa taxi gahapon kay 10,000. However, the law was amended today. Ang penalty na sa taxi karong adlaw is only 1,000. Karon, kung ikonbikto ni si Russell, pila man ang penalty nga imponer sa iyaha, guys? Is it 1,000 or 10,000? Anyone? Any volunteer? Balik ko na ko ha. Nakakuha mas problem.
Wala pa mo.
Balik, balik. Si Russell gahapon. Kailan mo taxi, guys? Amo nang duwa ka bata. Namang, kailan itong nasisiyo, di ba? Inyong anaon sa kuwan.
Na box, box.
Oh, box, box. Na imuhang ipagawas ang sisiyo. Inga na, kana taxi. let's say gahapon, kung masakpan ka nga mag-taxi, ang penalty is 10,000. Okay? But today, a law is passed amending the penalty of taxi into being a mere 1,000 na lang. Gahapon, pag-commit ni mo sa crime, 10,000. Karon nahimo na lang 1,000. Nay amendment ang balaod. Ningon ang Congress, ato na yung pag-amyan. Okay. Kasagaran na bang mag-taxi? Mga estudyante para ba niya? Wala ba kayo sila ikwarta? So ato lang pag-amyan. Question. Kung makumbikto ka ras for the crime that you commit katong taxi, pila may penalty ka hangay imponer sa imuha? Is it the 10,000 nga penalty katong pag-commit mo sa crime or only 1,000 katong amendment karong adlawa?
1,000 na ma'am. 1,000. Kay karon nang mga adlaw kay gapon mo to. Kay gapon mahal ba mo to 10,000 and then karon na amend man na 1,000 lang kay mo mi gibo.
Yeah, ning makata nga ang balaod prospective in application. Pasabot ang application para ra gyud na forward di gyud mo balik.
So, wait, mo naman to. Mo may giingon na balaod.
Yes, because that's one of the exceptions provided for in the law whenever a new statute dealing with a crime establishes a condition more lenient or favorable to the accused. Okay? Kay lenient man siya, paborable man siya sa imuha ras, maghatag na og retroactive effect. Pwedeng mubalik ang iyahang application. Correct? So since mas gamay man ang 1,000, bisan pag ang crime imong gi-commit a day before the passage of the 1,000 penalty, mo-apply na siya sa imuha because it is favorable to you. Kuha, Raras?
Okay, ma'am.
Kuha, guys? Apa mo diha, guys? Ano nga tuwag na mo? Yati dyan yung mga bataan eh. Apang kanyang exception has another exception. Bisan pa mag-favorable ni sa accused kung ang balaod mismo ni ingon nga wa ni retroactive application or kung si Russell in this case habitual delinquent. Okay? Unsa man ang habitual delinquent? Kung si Russell is someone within a period of 10 years from the date of his last conviction or release of any of the following crimes, na kumbikto siya for either robbery, theft, estafa or swindling, falsification, serious and less serious physical injuries, and is found guilty of any of the said crimes a third time or oftener. Okay? Kung nakihaan na siya within a period of 10 years for these crimes, katulo or kadaghan pa sa katulo, dili na to mo apply niya ang retroactive application. Okay? Kaya pasabot, ana, si Russell in this case, badlungon gid kaayo. Okay? Kani ko no, example, ayun na may answer. Mao ni akong example ganiha, katong jaywalking, of course, si X in this case is not correct because the law of the Philippines is binding to all persons living or sojourning in the Philippines. Since X is here to visit his chatmate, he is deemed to be bound by the laws of the Philippines. Kani guys, si X boxed Y to death when they met in Palawan. X is liable because the crime is committed within the Philippine territory. In this case, si X, kay Amerikano gihapon, iya ang gisuntok-suntok si Y, hantod namatay si Y. Liable siya, bisan pag Amerikano siya, because the crime is committed within the Philippine territory and penal laws are applicable to all who live or sojourn in the Philippine territory, di ba? But if si X and Y are married in the Philippines and Y decides to marry in the USA, Y cannot be prosecuted for bigamy here in the Philippines because the crime was not committed in our territory. Mausad niya ako ang example kaganiha. Alright? Klaro naman siguro na. Kanisad, ako asan yung example ganiha, si X raped Y. Rape was not yet a crime yesterday. So if a law is passed today making rape a crime, X cannot be prosecuted for the rape that he committed yesterday. Otherwise, that law on rape will become an ex post facto law. Kaya nga naman, mupinalize siya o sa kaak nga gibuhat dili pa krimen unya gihimo na kang akusado. Alright? So, kani is actually an example. Before we end our class, I will play this case digest of mine. If you have not yet subscribed di ay to my YouTube channel, please subscribe sa akong YouTube channel, guys. Darchi Iwaga sa niya. Makita mo dito ang mga lectures, makatunasan mo na yung mga case digest dito ng mga na-eye relationship sa criminal law. So malingaw mo atong channel. Anyway, I will play this. Kanishang People versus Sinosa is actually an example wherein the law would tell us nga na ay retroactive application. Diba akong balikon, ang characteristic of criminal law, it is general, it is territorial, it is prospective. Diba? Katong generality, territoriality, as well as the prospectivity. Karon kaning People versus Sinosa, makita nato diri nga ang balaod na ay retroactive application. Okay? Ang prospective application, ang atong gi-apply ani is an exception, which is the retroactive application. Nanuman, kaning balaod na ang RA 9262 gipasar after na sa commission of the crime aning Mrs. Sinosa. And you will see what the Supreme Court did in this case by watching this video. Tanawan ninyo guys. Mabati ra? Ras, nabati ito ni mo, Ras?
Hi guys, nabati, welcome Ras? Back to my channel. Today we will discuss the case of
Yes, ma'am.
Versus okay. Sinosa. This case actually led to the development of RA 9262 or VAUSE and release.
Dili madungog, ma'am.
Nawaan to car no, ma'am. Yoke mo mic.
Sorry. Sorry guys.
Case of okay, People balik. Versus Sinosa. To the development of RA 9262. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we will discuss the case of People versus Sinosa. This case actually led to the development of RA
9262.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we will discuss the case of People versus Sinosa. This case actually led to the development of RA 9262 or VAUSE and released women suffering from Batter-Dumann syndrome from criminal liability in case they commit a crime against their spouse or partners. Ug karon atong mahibawan kung unsa na ang Batter-Dumann syndrome o kung magamit ba ni siya nga depensa kung naa kay makommit ni crime against sa imuhang partner or imuhang spouse as the case may be. So, mag-start na ta sa pag-discuss sa facts case sa People versus Sinosa. And of course, as usual, we will start with the parties of the case. Ang parties here are Marivic and Ben. Okay? Marivic is the wife, Ben is the husband. So, unsa may nahitabo diri no? Si Marivic is actually married to Ben. And during pa sa first year sa ilahang marriage, they were actually happy like other couples, no? And then kinadugayan na nga nag-ipon sila, mag-away sila. And kaninga fights would sometimes or would oftentimes lead to violence. Kanimagod si Ben is actually palahubog. He's a drunkard. And every time masuko siya or mag-away sila ni Marivic, iyang kulatahon si Marivic. And every time kulatahon niya si Marivic, muli si Marivic sa ilaha. Ikuli ni Marivic sa ilaha, apason siya ni Ben. So in town, si Marivic, hoping nga maukiratanan, kikiapas man siya ni Ben, muli siya dito sa ilaha. But kani siya, permining na hitabo. Muli si Ben hubog, kulatahon siya, mulaya si Marivic. So yun na sad niya si Marivic ni Ben, and then mubalik na po si Marivic. This happened for the longest time sa ilahang marriage until one night, si Marivic nga 8 months pregnant napuno na tinitabo diri si Ben gikulata siya apan si Marivic nakadagan siya sa pikas kwarto dito sa kwarto sa ilahang mga anak and uman dito nagpabugnaw sa siya nagpabugnaw and then tungod kay nahadlok man siya sa iyahang bana nga pasagitan na sad siya unya ba si makuaan sad siya since 8 months pregnant siya gipatay ni Marivic ang iyahang bana nga natuog. Isood niya dito sa kwarto nga natuog ug iyang gipusin. Naturally, gikiha siya sa family ni Ben o parricide and she was actually convicted unya niabot ning kasuha ngadto sa Supreme Court ug niingon si Marivic nga I am actually justified in killing my husband because I am suffering from Batter-Dumann syndrome. And me being suffering from Batter-Dumann syndrome, that should constitute as a self-defense. O kung self-defense na siya, Your Honor, I should not incur any criminal liability since justified ko in killing my husband. So, abot ni sa Supreme Court. And ang issue dito, ni abot sa Supreme Court mo ni whether or not si Marivic can validly invoke battered woman syndrome as constituting self-defense. So, atong tanawon kung giunsa ni pag-decide sa Supreme Court. Pero ato sa din tanawon no, kung kano sa mga makaingon na ang babae is actually a battered woman. Tanawon ko na ito giunsa ni pag-storya or pag-desider sa Supreme Court. Yun ang Supreme Court, a battered woman has been defined as a woman who is repeatedly subjected to any forceful physical or psychological behavior by a man in order to coerce her to do something he wants her to do without concern of her rights. Battered women include wives or women in any form of intimate relationship with men. Furthermore, in order to be classified as a battered woman, the couple must go through the battering cycle at least twice. If it occurs a second time and she remains in the situation, she is defined as a battered woman. Kung sumaning kaha ang mga personality traits na ipakita or gi-exhibit sa mga battered women. Ningon ng Supreme Court, battered women exhibit common personality traits such as low self-esteem, traditional beliefs about the home, the family and the family sex role, emotional dependence upon the dominant male, the tendency to accept responsibility for the batterer's action, and the false hopes that the relationship will improve. Sadly, no, ang battered women, ang ilahang self-esteem is very low. Unya, ilahag yung pagtuo na ang babae is of lesser role ikumpara sa usa ka lalaki. Unya, kung kasagaran, masuko ang lalaki o kung masuko ang mangulata sa ilaha, feeling nila, ipulata sila because sila'y sad-an. Maukuno na ang common traits na gi-exhibit sa usa ka battered woman. And more graphically, dingon ng Supreme Court, the battered woman syndrome is characterized by the so-called cycle of violence, which has three phases. So naay cycle of violence, dingon ng Supreme Court. Unsa ka ni nga mga three phases sa cycle of violence? Ang una, the tension building phase, ikaduha, the acute battering incident, o ang ikatulo, the tranquil, loving, or at least the non-violent phase. Karon, sa desisyon sa Supreme Court, iyahag yun nga gi-illustrate kung kanus-a na ay tension building phase, kanus-a na ay acute battering incident, o kanus-a na ay tranquil loving phase. The Supreme Court said, during the tension building phase, minor battering occurs. It could be a verbal or slight physical abuse or another form of hostile behavior. So, dire, nainit na ang ulo sa mangulatahay. Okay? So, unya, dire sad ang babae, ang battered woman, iyang itry nga ipacify ang kalagot sa iyang batterer. Unya, ang ikaduhang nga phase sa cycle of violence ang acute battering incident. Here, kaninga incident is characterized by brutality, destructiveness, and sometimes, sadly, death. So, diri na gyud mangulata pag-ayo ang batterer. Unya, ang babae, dinhi iya na pong ma-realize or ang battered woman, dinhi niya ma-realize na wa na gyud siya mahimo para mapugnan ang batterer. And in fact, wala na lang siya buhaton, kundi pasagda na lang si batterer nga ikulata siya. And the final phase here is the tranquil period. The couple here experience a profound relief. Sa lain nga bahin, the batterer may show a tender and nurturing behavior towards his partner. So ang nangulata, diri sa tranquil loving phase, iyan ang labing-labingon. Ang iyahang asawa o ang iyang uya baron o ang iyahang partner, si case may be. Unya, si battered woman sad, nga gikulata, feeling sad niya, iyaha pong sa nga nung gikulata siya. Unya, in this case, kay gilabing-labing naman siya, ang iyaha pong pagtuo nga mausab ba ang batterer. Unya, iyaha na lang pasayloon in this phase. Pero enough ba ni yung mga cycle aron mapatay ni Narvik si Ben. Ningon ang Supreme Court, in any event, the existence of the syndrome in a relationship does not in itself establish the legal right of a woman to kill her abusive partner. Evidence must still be considered in the context of self-defense. In fact, ningon ang Supreme Court nga settled is our jurisprudence, however, is the rule that one who resorts to self-defense must face a real threat on one's life, and the peril sought to be avoided must be imminent and actual, not merely imaginary. And giklaro sa Supreme Court nga ang unlawful aggression is the most essential element of self-defense. It presupposes actual, sudden, and unexpected attack or an imminent danger thereof on the life or safety of a person. And then the Supreme Court said, in the present case, however, according to the testimony of Marivic herself, there was a sufficient time interval between the unlawful aggression of Ben and her fatal attack upon him. She had already been able to withdraw from his violent behavior and escape to their children's room. And during that time, he apparently ceased his attack and went to bed. The reality or even the imminence of a danger he posed had already ended altogether. And he was no longer in a position that presented an actual threat on her life or safety. And as a conclusion, in the Supreme Court, we reiterate the principle that aggression, if not continuous, does not warrant self-defense. In the absence of such aggression, there can be no self-defense, complete or incomplete, on the part of the victim. Therefore, in the Supreme Court, Marivic's killing of Ben was not completely justified under the circumstances. So, moto guys, ang People versus Sinosa, it is worth noting, no, despite the affirmation of the Supreme Court on the conviction of Marivic in this case, kanipong kasuha actually led to the development of RA 9262 or Anti-Violence Against Women and Children Act of 2004.
Nga nag-ingon nga if a woman kills her husband or a partner, as the case may be, she will be excused from criminal liability.
So, thank you very much sa pagtanaw. Before we end this video, I'd like to send a big shout out to my friends out there. Hi to Clint Alicante. Hi, Zark.
Okay. So, ang point na ko why I showed that nakakuha ra mo sa facts, basically, this was committed before the effectivity of RA 9262, no? After the passage of RA 9262, the law would tell us nga kung ang usaga ni kababay is suffering from battered woman syndrome and she commits a crime, no, as a result thereof, exempt siya from criminal liability because it will be considered as an act of self-defense. Before ani, kung ang usa ka babay, before sa RA 9262, this was before 2004. Kung i-commit ka crime, unya maingon ka nga self-defense to because battered woman ka, dili na siya i-grant sa Supreme Court. Mauni ang nahitabuan ng kasuha sa People versus Sinosa, gipatay niya iyang bana. Deprimim siya pula tahon, and according to her, she was suffering from battered woman syndrome and the reason why she killed her husband was because battered woman siya. So gihimo na niyang dipinsa. Pag abot sa Supreme Court, niuman ang Supreme Court, may balaod nga nag-ingon nga kung battered woman ka, pwede ka mo patay because self-defense ang imong gibuhat. So nakumbikto siya for parricide. However, months after the conviction, a law was passed and maoning balaod na. Ang RA 9262, which is precisely an example of the characteristic of prospectivity. Nga naman, ang RA 9262 niingon dito specifically sa balaod nga kung ang usa ka babay ha, kung ang usa ka babay mupatay sa iyang bana or sa iyang kaipon because she is suffering from battered woman syndrome, pwede niyang gamiton ang battered woman syndrome as a defense. Pwede nang ma-consider as self-defense.
Ma'am, nakipungutahan na, ma'am. Katong battered woman syndrome, ma'am, kay nag-involve yun sa kanang physical abuse mo. Mm. Or kanang pwede physical abuse ra ma'am.
Yeah. Physical abuse. Battered man. So nay battery nay physical good manifestation of the abuse. So battered woman. Siya. She's suffering from battered woman syndrome. Okay, the answer to that question is si Mrs. Sinosa here can actually go out na from the prison because RA 9262 is favorable man to her. Diba? Diba? Kung ingon man ta ato nga as an exception to the prospectivity of laws, pwede mo apply retroactively ang sa kabalaod kung favorable siya to the accused. Diba? Since RA 9262 would now tell us nga self-defense na kung naakay battered woman syndrome, pwede makagawa si Mrs. Sinosa. Before RA 9262, kung naka'y battered woman syndrome, dili man ka maka-interpose o self-defense because moingon man na ang judiciary o may balaod nga nag-ingon nga kung naka'y battered woman syndrome, makakommit ka crime niya, ang kanang crime yung gi-commit, makonsider na as self-defense. No. But since there was already RA 9262, that RA 9262 can actually be made applicable retroactively nga to sa kaso ni Mrs. Hinosa because it is favorable to Mrs. Hinosa. Kakuha na mo, guys. Diba, as a general rule, laws are prospective. Diba? Prospective ang application always looks forward. But if a law is favorable sa akusado, mupabor ba sa akusado ba? Na siya retroactive application. Okay? Dili lang na mo apply retroactively kung si akusado habitual delinquent. Katong-atong gihisgutan ganiha. Katong within 10 years, makonvict siya of those crimes enumerated. Diba? Kakuha mo guys. Naklaro ra ba guys? Daryl. Yes, Daryl.
Ma'am, katong yung mungingon nga, dito ma'am, dito, radio, dito?
Dito man. Retroactive.
Oh, kala ma'am, ma'am. Hmm. Kala naman siya ma'am, exist na siya ma'am, kung existing na ang law ma'am. Na ang law.
Ha?
Kanang jato radio act jato eh limot eh
retroactive
retro
ah, retroactive man ba
mo retro ba mo balik ba mo retroact lang ang application sa balaod kung paborable sa akusado.
Oh, ma'am applicable ra na ma'am kung existing na ang law ma'am na ang law ma'am ba di
dili na because naghisgot man ta og prospectivity naghisgot ag balaod karon ba let's say di ba katotong gisgutan karon gahapon wala pa'y balaod nya karon wala pa'y balaod gahapon nga mag-imponer og tax sa tanang mga gwapo example ani pero karong adlawa naay balaod nga nag-ingon nga tanang gwapo taksa na kakuha ka so kaning balaod mo apply ra ni today onwards okay ang iyang application karong adlawa og sa maabot pang mga adlaw dili mo balik gahapon mo nay pasabot sa prospective pero kaning balaod ra na mubalik ni siya og apply sa kagahapon kung paborable ni nga balaod. Mao na siyang itawag na tog retroactive application. Mo retroact ba? Balik. Retroactive. So katong atong gisgutan ganiha nga People versus Sinosa since ang RA 9262 gipasarman after na nakonbikto si Mrs. Sinosa kakuha ka, 'di ba? After nakonbikto si Mrs. Sinosa, gipasar ang RA 9262. Niya katong balaod na kay paborable man kang Mrs. Sinosa. Paborable man.
Retro, ma'am. Retro.
Oh, muna nga, mo retro ang iyang application. Kakuha mo, guys?
Gets na ko, ma'am.
Gets na? Okay. How about...
Kasi naman paunta na unta.
Yeah. How about Daryl? Nag-gets ni mo, Daryl?
Kura, ma'am.
Taba na, Daryl.
Ha? Sure?
Okay, na, nalibog siguro na ganina mo. Na-confess okay. Na.
Okay. Balik ko na to. Characteristic, unsa to? Generality. Generality, applicable siya sa tanang tao. Territoriality, applied siya within the Philippine territory. Ang ikatulo, prospective. Pasabot ana nga ang application pangadto sa karon antod sa umaabot nga adlaw. Dili mo balik ba? Panalitan na ay gipasar nga balaod karon, ang application na magsugod karon hangtod sa ugma, sunod ugma. Dili ang application gahapon. Kakuha mo? Pero mo apply na siya, mo retroact, mo apply na dito sa mga panghitabo kagahapon o sa mga miaging adlaw kung kanang balaod na paborable sa akusado. Mao na siya ang retroactive application. As a general rule, prospective ta. 'Di ba? We look forward. Pero kung favorable ang balaod, we look backward. We retroact. Kakuha mo, guys? Naklaro, guys? Uy, tubag sa muli, ha?
Oh, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Oh, ma'am.
Iyong yes, ma'am.
Nangatug na mo. Ay, sagtug. Kajut lang. Kay... Sayang kayo atong discussion ba? Anyway, I hope inyo nang naklaro. And if na may question, ay na ko. Unsa may pangutana na to? Ma'am. Na may mga questions? Ophelia, yes, Ophelia.
Wala, ma'am, wala.
Wala ra? Okay. Any more questions? Ang sunod na itong panagkita, guys, ang sunod na itong klase, kay ako na lang i-record ha, then ako i-uploads ako ang kanang YouTube. Ako ra ibutang sa inyohang GC para inyo rang ma-access. Okay ra? Or ganahan mong klase?
Mas maayo, ma'am. Mas maayo.
Mas maayo ra YouTube, no? Para dali ra ninyo ma-access, no? Anytime. Unsa may maayo? Or maginanig hapon ta? Guys.
Pwede ra YouTube, ma'am.
YouTube. Sige, 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 sige. Sige. So, thank you, guys. Naram mo nasabtan, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, daghan.
Okay. So, thank you very much sa inyong presensya karon. I hope maka-catch up ra mo ha because in this subject, we will have an exam. After nato mahuman og discuss tanan mag-exams ko ani and I hope inyong mga classmates inyo ingnon to catch up with the discussion. All right? So thank you kaayo guys ha and pwede na mong mo exit mga tog na ta or mga snack na ta unsa man. Amping mo kanunay. Thank you.
Bye ma'am. Thank you.
Bye. Thank you Ross.
Thank you ma'am.
Thank you.
Bye ma'am. Thank you. Thank you ma'am.
Thank you Niv.
Yo ma'am, thank you.
Thank you guys.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, thank you.
Bye, ma'am.
Thank you, Ads. Thank you, Daryl. Thank you, everyone.